capital A 4 comma minus 4 and B 9 comma 6 lies on y square is equal to 4x and a point C on arc AOB such that area of ACD is minimum, then the point C is dashed. Here is given parabola y square is equal to 4x. This is the parabola y square is equal to 4x. So the given point capital A is 4 comma minus 4 and B point is 9 comma 6 and we take AD point C is 80 square comma 280. Then the area of the triangle ACD is minimum. Then the point C is dash. So here is given parabola y square is equal to 4x, that is 4a is equal to 4, a is equal to 1. Therefore the point C is 80 square comma 280. Substituting a is equal to 1 in this equation, the point C is t square comma 2t. Then area of the triangle ACB, area is equal to half into first point 4 comma minus 4, that is 4 minus 4 1 and second point 9 comma 6 1 and the third point t square 2t 1. So area is equal to half into, find the depth of this value, 4 into 6 into 6 minus 2t plus 4 into 9 minus t square plus 1 into 9 into 2 18 t minus 60 square. So that is equal to area is equal to half into 4 into 6 24 minus 4 into 2 80 plus 4 into 9 36 minus 4 t square plus 18 t minus 60 square. So therefore area is equal to half into, here is minus 4t square minus 60 square, that is minus 5t square minus 80 plus 18t, that is 10t, 24 plus 36, that is 60. So that is area is equal to, take 2 common, 1 by 2 into minus 5t square plus 5t plus 30. Here is 2 to cancel, therefore area is equal to minus 5t square plus 5t plus 30. Therefore this area is minimum, that is dA by dt is equal to 0. So derivative of minus 5t square is minus 10t, 5t derivative is 5 plus 30 derivative is 0, that is equal to 0. Therefore 10t is equal to 5. Therefore, t is equal to 5 by 10, that is equal to 1 by 2. Substituting t value in the given point C, that is t square comma 2t, that is equal to C. T square is 1 by 2 whole square comma 2 into 1 by 2. 1 by 2 whole square is 1 by 4. 2 cancel, that is 1. Therefore, the coordinates of C is 1 by 4 comma 1. That is answer. The circuits x square plus y square minus 16x minus 20y plus 164 is equal to r square and x minus 4 whole square plus y minus 7 whole square is equal to 36 intersecting at 2 points. Then the condition is these two circuits are intersecting at 2 points. That means modulus of R1 minus R2 which is less than C1, C2 less than R1 plus R2. This is the condition for two circuits are touching each other. So first center of the first circuit C1 is 8 comma 10 and the radius of the first circuit R1 is equal to 8 square is 64, 10 square is 100 minus 164 minus 164 plus r square. Here is 64 plus 100, 164 cancel, that is equal to r. So center of the second circle C2 is 4 comma 7 and the radius r2 is equal to, here is 36 is 6 square, that is 6. These two circles are intersecting at 2 points, that is first we find the value of C1, C2. C1, C2 is distance between the centers, that is equal to 8 minus 4 whole square plus 10 minus 7 whole square. 8 minus 4 is 4 square, that is 16. 10 minus 7, 3 is 9, that is equal to 16 plus 9 is equal to root 25 is equal to 5. The given circles are intersecting at two points, that is modulus of R1 minus R2, which is less than C1, C2, which is less than R1 plus R2. R1 is R, minus R2 is 6, and C1, C2 value is 5, which is less than R plus 6. So first condition, R minus 6 less than 5, that is R less than 5 plus 6, that is 11. And 5 less than R plus 6, that is R plus 6 greater than 5, that is R greater than 1. So for the values of R, R belongs to greater than 1 and less than 1, that is written as 1, 11. This is the answer, that R value belongs to 1, 11. Find the eccentricity of the hyperbola which is passes through 4, 2 and whose center is 0, 0. Length of the transverse axis is 4 and the transverse axis lies along on x-axis. Here is given length of the transverse axis is given. Length of the transverse axis is 2a, that is equal to 4, that is a is equal to 2. So an equation of the hyperbola, x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to 1. This equation along transverse axis is along x axis. This is x square by a square. A square value is 4 and y square by b square is equal to 1. This hyperbola passes through the point 4, 2. Substituting this 4, 2 in this equation, x square 16 by 4 minus y square 4 by b square is equal to 1. That is 4 by b square is equal to 16 by 4 minus 1, that is equal to 16 minus 4, 12 by 4, that is 4 3 times cancelled, that is equal to 3. Therefore 4 by b square is equal to 3, b square is equal to 4 by 3. This is the value of b square. Now we find the eccentricity of the hyperbola. Eccentricity of the hyperbola is equal to under root of 1 plus b square by a square, that is equal to 1 plus b square value is 4 by 3 by a square value is 4, here is 4, 4 cancelled, that is equal to 1 plus 1 by 3, 1 plus 1 by 3, that is equal to 4 by 3, therefore e is equal to root 4 value is 2, that is 2 by root 3. The eccentricity of the hyperbola is 2 by root 3, that is the answer. X is equal to 3 tan t and y is equal to 3 sec t. Then find the value of d square y by dx square at x is equal to pi by 4 in dash. So here is given x is a function in t, that is x is equal to 3 tan t and y is equal to 3 sec t. First we find the derivative of x, that is dx by dt is equal to 3 into tan t derivation secant square t. And the derivative of y is dy by dt into 3 into sec t derivation sec t into tan t. So now we find dy by dx, therefore dy by dx is equal to dy by dt by dx by dt. Dy by dt value is 3 sec t tan t by 3 secant square t. Here is 3 cancel. Secant t cancel, that is dy by dx is equal to tan t by sec t, that is tan t is sin t by cos t by sec t is 1 by cos t. Again cos t cancel, that is equal to sin t. Therefore dy by dx is equal to sin t. Now you find second derivative d square y by dx square. Dy by dx derivative is d square y by dx square sin t derivation cos t into derivative of t is dt by dx. This is written as cos t into 1 by dx by dt. Dx by dt value is 3 secant square t, that is cos t into 1 by 3 secant square t. 1 by secant square t is cos square t, that is 1 by third into cos cube t. This is the value of d square y by dx square. This d square y by dx square, d square y by dx square at x is equal to pi by 4, that is equal to 1 by third into cos cube of pi by 4, that is equal to 1 by 3 into cos 45 is 1 by root 2, that is 1 by root 2 whole cube. 1 by 3 into 1 by root 2 whole cube is 1 by 2 root 2, that is equal to 1 by 3 into 2, 6 root 2. This is the value of d square y by dx square at x is equal to pi by 4 is 1 by 6 root 2. That is the answer. Two lines are in 3D are x is equal to ay plus b and z is equal to cy plus d, and x is equal to a dash z plus b dash and y is equal to c dash z plus d dash are perpendicular to each other, then which of the following statements is true? That is, here given the lines are x is equal to ay plus b and z is equal to cy plus d. So this is x minus b is equal to ay and x minus b by a is equal to y and z minus d is equal to cy and z minus d by c is equal to y. Therefore, the equation of the line is x minus b by a is equal to y by 1 is equal to z minus d by c. This is the equation of the first line. And the given second lines are x is equal to a dash z plus b dash and y is equal to c dash z plus d dash. This is x minus b dash is equal to a dash z. This is x minus b dash by a dash is equal to z. And from this one, y minus d dash is equal to c dash z. Y minus d dash by c dash is equal to z. From these two equations, x minus b dash by a dash is equal to y minus d dash by c dash is equal to z by 1. This is another line equation. Given these two lines are perpendicular, that is direction cosines of the direction cosines of first line is equal to a comma 1 comma c, and direction cosines of second line is equal to a dash comma c dash comma 1. These two lines are perpendicular, that is a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 is equal to 0. That is, a1 a2 is a into a dash plus 1 into c dash plus c into 1 c, that is equal to 0. This is the condition for the given two lines are perpendicular. Here is given x is equal to sin inverse of sin 10 and y is equal to cos inverse of cos 10. Then the value of y minus x is dash. Here is given x is equal to sin inverse of sin 10. This sin 10, the value in radians. In radians, sin inverse of sin 10 is written as sin inverse of sin of 3 pi minus 10. That is equal to the value is 3 pi minus 10. And y is equal to cos inverse of cos 10. This cos inverse of cos 10 is written as cos inverse of cos of 4 pi minus 10. That is equal to 4 pi minus 10. Here is asking y minus x. That is, y minus x is equal to y value 4 pi minus 10 minus 3 pi minus 10. That is equal to 4 pi minus 10 minus 3 pi plus 10. Here is 10 cancel. That is equal to 4 minus 3 pi is 5. Therefore, the value of y minus x is equal to 5. That is the answer.